Yeah, so it's a really complicated scenario when you're in a tight space. I mean, this is it's all about, the use case of the camera. So for me, we're in a plane, we have tiny bit of room, and we can't use something larger. We're really stuck using, I mean, the biggest bang for our buck, and that was the S3. And you're putting this camera out the window of the plane, shooting another plane flying at like 60 miles an hour, 100 miles an hour. And that was really crucial, is being able to have that functionality. You're not overheating. You're able to have really intuitive dial controls switching back and forth. And I think the beauty here was the real kind of question mark, the what if, was how good of quality is this slow motion, right? And I was blown away. I mean, it was incredible. It felt like we were shooting off of a gimbal, right? Up in the air, shooting this other plane right below us. And that, for me, it's really about testing it in those real world scenarios. I don't want to advocate for a camera that a DP or a director couldn't get behind and say, I know I can nail this shot. And what it does is you realize it opens up a whole new world of what you can do, because you can literally see in the dark. I mean, that is the true game changer. And I mean, that tagline, it's real, it's raw. And that's what the camera really truly does for you. It opens up a world of possibilities where normally tripods are like a ball and chain you'd have over your back and you'd have to drag around. You don't need that. Thank you.